UVB, or ultraviolet illumination of the blood, is a treatment where we take blood out, put it underneath an ultraviolet light. The ultraviolet light has specific properties that can kill off certain pathogens and can stimulate the immune system of the body. Ultraviolet sanitation has been used for 40 or 50 years. When we expose the blood to ultraviolet light, not only does it kill off pathogens and detoxify the blood, but it stimulates a higher oxygen carrying capability, which stimulates the immune system. The UVB is most specifically used for acute and chronic infections, commonly chronic fatigue, Lyme disease, or sometimes even unnamed chronic infections, because it doesn't matter what the infection is, virus or bacteria, Lyme disease or Epstein-Barr, the body's immune system gets triggered with ultraviolet, and no viruses or bacteria survive well in an ultraviolet environment. So the most common treatment for the ultraviolet is acute or chronic infection, and that can be viral or bacterial, or even in the case of Lyme, which is a spirochete, and the co-infections associated with it that sometimes we can't even name. The treatment consists of an IV treatment where we take some blood out, a small amount, put it underneath an ultraviolet light, add oxygen in the form of ozone, and deliver it directly back into the body, supercharged to stimulate immune system and clear toxins from the body. So the most common treatment for bacterial infections is antibiotics. There are not many effective treatments for viruses, and the option of using ultraviolet is a non-pharmacologic treatment. There's no drug involved. It's only ultraviolet light and oxygen, and so many patients that have chosen to do ultraviolet illumination of the blood, or photoluminescence, have already tried those antibiotics or have adverse reactions to drugs and pharmaceutical options, that this leaves them an option to try a natural remedy. The most common side effects associated with ultraviolet is a detoxification reaction. Sometimes it's called a Herxheimer reaction, or Herxheimer reaction, which is kind of like a cold or flu-like symptoms, a detoxification process that people feel like either a hangover or like they have a cold or flu, and that usually lasts a day or so. The next most common side effect is localized irritation at the IV site. Will there be some bruising or black and blue at the site of the needle? However, antibiotics, which are very effective for many medications, sometimes have side effects. Certain antibiotics have many side effects. Leviquin has been associated with tendon rupture. The use of antibiotics has been associated with developing opportunistic infections, yeast infections, or even serious infections like C. diff.